Hello and welcome to your YouTube channel. I hope you have already subscribed the channel. I am Chanchala Tiwari, your companion in this journey. So let's see what I have brought for you today. Tell me, how do we communicate with people? What we do to tell our thoughts, ideas, express our point of view? What we do? So generally, there are two means of communication. Verbal and non-verbal. So what is verbal communication? So whenever you are doing some oral communication, that comes under verbal communication. Now what is this oral communication? So when we are talking to someone face to face or even in distant communication, that is verbal communication. If you want to talk with someone, we go to someone and we talk in front of them or in a group. So that is oral communication, in which you are using your speaking skills. And another type of verbal communication is written communication. What is written communication? When you want to put forth your ideas or thoughts into a written form, that is written communication. Like letters, emails, fax, memos, telegram, notice, reporting, books, novels, articles, all these are written form of communication. Through all these things, we want to communicate what we want to say, isn't it? So, this all comes under written communication. Now, what is non-verbal communication? So, you can see this picture. Aapko kya batana padega? What he is in mood of? Iska mood kaisa hai? I don't think so. By looking to this picture, we can tell that this person is very angry. Bahut gusse mein hai ye. So, in non-verbal communication, this gesture and postures tell you what you want to communicate. There is another way, that is signaling. Like on traffic signal, you must have seen this traffic signal where there are signals of getting ready or to stop or to walk. So through these signals, the traffic men do not say you to stop or say. They just use the signals or they use some sign languages as well. So these are the various means of communication through which you can communicate what you are thinking or what you want to tell or what you want to inform to someone, verbal or non-verbal. In any means you can use or choose to communicate it. So in order to communicate, whether you want to do verbal communication or non-verbal communication, you must have something. So how to make oral communication? And for that, you have to have speaking skill and listening skill. Because when you are doing oral communication, you are talking to someone and that person must know how to listen and how to observe, and you must know how to speak. So these two skills are very important for oral communication: speaking skill and listening skill. And how do we make written communication? Which skill must we have for this? So that is writing skill and reading skill. Without writing and reading skill, we cannot communicate in a written form. Unless and until you know what to write, how to write, and unless and until you know how to read, you won't be able to communicate in written form. So these are the different, as a whole, for communication skills, you must have all these four skills of listening, reading, writing, and speaking. Now, before communicating, please give me the answer of these questions. Which mode of communication is more authentic? ज़्यादा सटीक मोड ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन क्या है? कहते हैं ना, कहीं लिखा हुआ है क्या जो ऐसा कर रहे हो? So, which mode is more authentic? Which you believe more? Which mode of communication is more specific and acceptable? If something is in written form, do you believe more on that or not? Like if you are making some agreement, अगर वो सिर्फ बोल के किया जाए, तो will you believe on that? I don't think so. Which mode of communication have greater impact? Zyada impactful kya hota hai? And which mode of communication has greater reach? How you can reach to maximum number of people through communication? Like if you are talking to someone or a group of people, your message would be communicated to a limited number of people. But if you are communicating through writing, like if you have written some book, many people are reading that book. Even you also don't know as a writer who are reading your books. So the reach is greater in written communication. Which mode of communication can be preserved for longer period of time? You can see these books. These are Vedas and Bhagavad Gita. These are written way 5000 years back, but still they are preserved as it is in written form. So books, letters, emails, agreements, or anything else, whichever is in written form, we believe on it more, we find it more authentic, and we find it more acceptable. So it is written communication, isn't it? Don't you agree with me that written communication is more powerful? Now, what is writing skill? For written communication, you must have writing skills. So what does this writing skill mean? So writing skill is basically a skill through which you can express your point of views or ideas or thoughts in a written form. That is writing skill. So it can be for presenting your ideas. You can writing skill can be used for presenting your ideas, like if you are writing some blog or if you are writing for some advertisement. Through this you are presenting the idea, and that will come under writing skill. For that you need to have writing skills. If you want to inform about something, like emails, through emails you want to inform, or through application, letter, memo, reporting, noticing, all these things are used for giving information, and these are also in written form, so you must have writing skill for it. Preparing reports or summary, if you are writing some research paper, or if you are doing some surveys, there you have to write the summary of that, and for that also you have to write the things. And like company annual report, these are the examples of reporting, or survey report or research report. So these are different examples of reporting. If you want to compile some facts and figures, like textbook, articles, journals, these textbooks, what the writers of textbook, what they do, they used to compile all the facts and figures relating to the topic into one place, and then that compiling becomes a book. So this also needs writing skill. Now if you want to narrate a story through fictional or non-fictional writing, so script writing, this all comes under writing skill. Documenting some works, like newspaper reporting or editorial or column writing. So if you want to document something which had happened, so that is also a kind of writing. Writing proposals for some research work, or for doing some project with some companies or with some government agencies. So for all these things, you need to have the writing skill. So writing skill is used for everything, whatever is there in the written form, that for all these things, you need to have the writing skills. Now, what are the basic ingredients of writing skills? What do we exactly need for putting our thoughts on paper? What do we need? So first of all, you need a thought. Basically, you need a thought to write, isn't it? Jab tak koi thought nahi hoga, koi idea nahi hoga, what will you write about? So, and for that, you must need a purpose or reason or cause. Kyun likh rahe hain? Why are you writing that? So that need to be very clear in your mind. Then a format. Many a times there are formats of writing. Like if you are writing some letter or notice or report, there is a fixed format. Accordingly, you have to write. So many a times if you are writing books, that is generally of free of format, you develop your own format and accordingly you write. But if you are writing some reports or something else, there is a fixed format. A good set of vocabulary. Agar shabd hi nahi honge, then how will you write? So you must have a good set of vocabulary. Then spellings, grammatical skills, punctuation marks really makes a difference into the sentences. These punctuation marks are really important. Where to put the comma and where to put the full stop is very important. They completely change the meaning of the sentence. So put it very carefully. You must know how to put them. And with practice it comes. Don't worry about it. Ability to construct sentences. You must know how to construct a sentence. If you do not know, there is a process of understanding how to construct sentences. Compositional skills you must know, like how to organize whatever you have written, what will be the sequence, what will be the flow, what discourse you can use. So these all comes under compositional skills. So these are the basic ingredients which you must have for your writing. Okay. understanding about the type of reader for whom you are writing. Who is your reader? Your examiner, your boss, your employer, your student, general people, your mother, your father, if you are writing a letter to your friends. Who is the reader? Because unless and until you know your reader, you won't be able to decide what language you have to use into that. So before writing it, make it very clear in your mind for whom you are writing. And accordingly, you have to set your tone, language, rhythm, everything in writing. Now, what are the steps which you need to follow for writing? So the very basic step is pre-writing. In pre-writing, you have to think about all those things which I have already told you in my previous slide. So, give a good thinking before pre-writing. While writing, you have to think what you want to write. Just write it down, whatever you have thought in your pre-writing session. Revising is very important. It's not that your writing will be very good and flowful in your first draft. So, you need to revise it several times. Take help from others also in revising. Editing, whether any spelling mistake is there, whether grammatical mistake is there, whether you have missed some punctuation mark, what things you have written, is it in flow? All these things will be done in the editing part. And finally, you can publish whatever you have written. So, these are the steps which you need to follow for writing anything. And if you are beginning to write, then these steps must be followed. Now, before writing, you must answer these questions. This is your pre-writing exercise which you need to do. Like what to write, what you exactly want to write, what type of writing it will be, whether it will be descriptive writing, exploratory writing, or it will be a narration, or it will be a report writing. So, what you want to write actually? What are my objectives to write? Why are you writing? For whom you are writing? Are you writing a formal thing? Are you writing informal things? Formal writing or informal writing? You have to decide. And accordingly, you have to choose. How much time do you have to write? Are you writing in an exam there where you have limited time period? Within that period, you have to write. So, that need to be taken care. Suppose if you are writing a notice, there is a time limit. If you are writing in an exam, there is a time limit. So, you must understand for whom you are writing. If you are writing it for your examiner, accordingly you have to write. How much time do you have? There is always a fixed word limit, like in how much time to write. There is a fixed word limit in like notice writing or letter writing sometimes if you are writing formal letters. So, you have to understand and accordingly you have to write. Do you know your readers for whom you are writing? Do they belong to adult age group? Do they belong to an old age group? Do they belong to younger generation? For whom you are writing? Who is your reader? Your boss? Your employer? Your teacher? Who is your reader? What format do you need to follow? If you are writing some formal writing, like suppose you are writing notice. So, there is a fixed format of writing notices. There is a fixed format of writing letters or reports. So, what do you need to follow? If you want me to make different videos for this, because it will take a long period of time to make you understand what are the format of different kind of writing, I will definitely make different video for it. Whether you have to write in first person, second person, third person, is there any specific type of demand from your reader which you want to write? Suppose if you are writing for children and it's a story, then you have to use specific set of vocabulary for that kind of reader, which they understand, which they can connect with to understand is there any demand. You can also collect some informations from several people what they are liking. Specific language need to be followed. If you are writing for your teacher or examiner, tone of the writing and the language of the writing should be accordingly. If you are writing for your friends, if you are writing email to your friend, language will be completely different. So, specific language need to be followed. Whether you have to follow the language or not, that also you need to understand. So, let's see what are the things which you have to do in pre-writing. As I have already told you that pre-writing is a very important aspect of writing. You can see in this picture that one girl is just sitting on with the laptop and not able to write anything in the first week. She is just thinking what to write, what to do. And after a week, she is writing. So it take a time what to write. It's not that kadhai mein dala, chhok lagaya and it will come out. No. You have to think. You have to think a lot. You have to do lot of things to understand what you exactly want to write. And for that, first of all, you need to understand your theme of writing. And how you will understand what on what theme you want to write. And for this, you have to do brainstorming and mind mapping. These two are very important aspect and very important steps to be followed for writing. Now, what is the difference between brainstorming and mind mapping? So, brainstorming is basically storming your brain. The mark pe khub zor dalna hai so that you can come up with an idea. Kis pe likhoge? That will give you an idea about the topic on what you want to write. Okay. Now, mind mapping. So, mind mapping, after understanding what will be your topic for writing, you have to find out what will be there into that writing. What will be the steps? What will be the sequences? So, that need to be understood. Like, if you want to mind map on school, if you want to write about on school, suppose through brainstorming, you got that you want to write about school. So, in mind map, you will write about what kind of schools you want to write, how you will write. So, these two steps are very important. Develop an understanding about the central idea of the topic. After getting your topic, what is your central idea? Exactly what you want to tell. Kya kehna chahte ho aap us writing ke through. So, that need to be focused. Now, doing proper research about the topic. Before writing, as I have already told you, the written things are more authentic. People find it more authentic. So, don't write anything. If you want to write authentic, do a proper research on that topic. And don't go only with one type of search engine. Just Google kiya, first page khula, jo bhi mila, wahi likh diya. That is not proper researching. Go to different platforms and different search engines and try to find out a common thing which is authentic. Because nowadays people are generally doing research on internet. So that is why I have given this example. So do a proper research before writing. Collect information, facts and figures. That is also very important for your writing purpose. And that also makes your writing very effective. So this is how you need to build up your wall of writing. Suppose you are writing a page, you want to write a page. So brick by brick, that means sentence by sentence, you have to make your paragraph of writing. So making a rough sketch about the topic, idea, plot, character, story, that you need to do. Before writing the final one, you have to think about what will be, what kind of characteristics will it be if you are writing a story. Or if you are writing about a paragraph, what are the, suppose you are writing on a pollution. So what is pollution? What are the different types? How does it pollution occur? How? What are the remedies to come out of from pollution? How we can solve this issue? How to spread awareness? So all these things need to be considered before writing. Writing an outline of the content is also very important. Like what you want to write. Suppose if you want to write a thing on school. So as I have already told you. So are you going to write for a primary school? Are you going to write for secondary schools? Are you going to write for higher schools? Or are you going to write universal type of schooling? What is the schooling going on all over the places? Again, if you have decided to write about primary school, what you exactly want to write in this? Because that is also a very vast topic to write. Or do you want to write about the teachers of a primary school? Or you want to write about the students? Or you want to write about something else, the whole school system, or you want to write about the administration. So you have to decide what you want to write about. And then again, if you have decided, suppose you want to write about teachers. So for them also, what you want to write? Teachers' professionalism, teachers' absenteeism, teachers' behavior in the school, teacher teaching skills. So there are several points which you can write about. And then you can finally, if you have written the things, you can always sequence them through numbering. So, which will be the first point which you want to put into that. So, this will really help you in writing part. And this is a pre-writing activity. Before writing the things onto a paper, you have to do this before writing. This will really help you. Now, what things which you need to do while writing? So, first thing which you need to do is don't worry. Don't worry about right and wrong. क्या होगा अगर गलत हो गया तो कुछ भी नहीं होगा, कोई आपको फांसी नहीं लगाएगा। सो डोंट वरी, इफ इट इज रॉन्ग फाइन, इफ इट इज राइट फाइन, वी विल डू इट, यू जस्ट नीड टू फर्स्ट राइट। नाउ हाउ टू राइट, सो कंस्ट्रक्ट द सेंटेंसेस एज पर द माइंड मैपिंग डन बाय यू, एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू, लाइक यू हैव ऑलरेडी सीक्वेंस्ड इट, सो अरेंज देम, कंस्ट्रक्ट द सेंटेंसेस। इफ देयर यू हैव ओनली रिटन द वर्ड्स लाइक टीचर स्टूडेंट, देन मेक इट विद अ फुल सेंटेंस एंड देन कंस्ट्रक्ट इट। Start with making simple sentences and don't forget to make different type of sentences as per the need. Like if the requirement is of assertive sentence or imperative sentence or of negative, interrogative, whatever type of sentence is required, accordingly make use of whatever tools you have to make and make it simple sentences. It will be easier for the beginners. Organize the sentences into a sequential manner. A flow need to be maintained. Don't put like a हमारे देश का पॉपुलेशन 135 मिलियन है, हमारे देश के प्रधानमंत्री ये है, एंड देन यू आर राइटिंग हमारे देश का नाम भारतवर्ष है। सो दिस इज नॉट द सीक्वेंस ऑफ पुटिंग थिंग्स, लाइक इफ यू आर डूइंग 1 2 3 फॉर राइटिंग एंड इफ यू आर राइटिंग 5 4 1 2 3, दिस इज नॉट सीक्वेंस। ओके, व्हाट इज सीक्वेंस? सीक्वेंस इज 1 then 2 then 3 then 4, सो दिस इज द सीक्वेंस, एंड इफ इट इज नॉट इन सीक्वेंस योर रीडर विल नॉट रीड द थिंग्स। लाइक इफ यू आर, इफ यू कैन सी द एग्जाम्पल हियर, if this is a burger, so the top layer is like introduction, the main part is your body, that is your paragraph, and then conclusion, again a layer of bread is there. So you have to arrange your writing accordingly. Include all necessary facts and figures to support your writing, that is also important. Like I have given you the example, Bharat ka population 135 million, then you are supporting it with some evidence. India is overpopulated country, but how it is overpopulated, unless and until you will make some comparisons, nobody will understand that it is overpopulated. You can always compare this with some other countries, then only someone will understand. So it is very important to include all the facts and figures into your writing. Consider the flow of sentence, whether it is coming into a flow or not. If you are reading it, whether it is flow in flow or not. Take care of the format. If you are writing a notice, suppose I have already told you, or if you are writing a letter, note, these have some fixed formats which you need to understand and accordingly you have to write. Make divisions, parts and points. This is very important. You have to make some bullet points in your writing so that it can be attractive. If you are just keep on writing lines after lines, there is no highlighter, there is no bold letters, there is no pictures, there is no, means if you are writing a book, so you have to make divisions and parts, so that will make your writing very attractive. Consider the understanding level of your reader and accordingly use the language. Who is your reader? Again and again I am telling this. Agar aapke examiner ke liye aap likh rahe ho, what kind of language you are going to use? So accordingly you have to write. If you have to maintain the tone of your writing, it has to be very polite. Make the write-up as if you are talking to the reader. Don't make it very boring. जैसे बात करते हैं, अकॉर्डिंगली यू राइट इट, इट विल बी इंटरेस्टिंग। एंड दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, डोंट अज्यूम, प्लीज डोंट अज्यूम दैट द रीडर वुड नो द थिंग्स विदाउट मेंशनिंग। दिस इज वेरी फुलिश टू डू। इफ यू आर राइटिंग इन द एग्जामिनेशन, योर एग्जामिनर नो द थिंग्स बट स्टिल यू हैव टू राइट, एंड इफ यू हैव मिस्ड आउट सम पॉइंट, आप वहां जाके एक्सप्लेन नहीं कर सकते। So don't assume that your reader is knowing anything. Just put all the informations, whatever you have about the thing. Because assuming that your reader is knowing something, that will really miss the flow. And that's really have a bad impact. So don't assume that your reader know anything. Just write everything. This is very important, revising and editing. Because in your first draft, you have just written everything, whatever you want to write. But in your revision and editing section, you will come to a concrete part of it. So give a thorough reading as well as loud reading. So I'm sorry that here the spelling of thorough is wrong. It should be T-H-O. Okay. I'm sorry for this. So you should read your writings thoroughly. Unless and until you read it thoroughly, you won't be able to understand where you have missed the flow. So this is very important. or else you can ask someone else to read and listen. Then also you will be know that what things you have missed out. Sometimes what happens if we have written ourselves, we miss few things. But when we listen to it, we find out, oh ho, ye to galat hai. So try to listen, try to ask someone else to read and listen it. It will help you. Find out the mistakes or find out the missing transition or flow. When you will read thoroughly and when you will read it loudly or if you listen it, you will find out the flow is missing. Then you can put that into it. Use discourses to maintain the flow and transition, like and, as if, however, does, although. These are the transitional words which help you to make the transition from one place to another. So use them. Okay. Like however. So this is one discourse. Okay. So use them. There are many discourses which you can find out. Add a section if missed earlier. While revising and editing, it mostly we find that we have missed something. So add a section, which is very important. Sometimes what we do when we write for the first time, we missed few things. So if you have missed earlier, then please add a section. There is no harm and problem in doing that. Or else you can also remove a section if it is repetitively done. Sometimes it happens that while writing, we don't know that we are repeating the things. So remove it. Or rephrase the sentences if you find that the meaning is not coming clearly. So you can always rephrase the sentences as if required. These things are really important to make your writing very effective. You may be in this situation. You may have to use lot of things while writing. So don't worry about it. Just go through it. Keep the tone of your writing polite and unbiased. If you are writing a letter to your superiors or if you are making some recommendations, so your tone of writing should be very polite. So use modal auxiliary verbs. Use unbiased tone. Don't be support someone else to give preferences or something like that. Avoid them, especially in academic writing. Reorganize or rearrange the parts or sections to maintain the sequence and flow of write-up. If you need to rearrange, suppose if you have written one line after second and you find that no, this line should be the first one, so rearrange it. There is no harm. Check the grammar, spellings and punctuation marks during your revision and editing time. This is the editing part. You have to check whether grammatically it is correct or not, whether the spellings of the words are correct or not. Nowadays, if you are typing on laptop and all, there is always a grammar check and spelling check. You can always put it on and then you can check it. Punctuation marks, as I have already told you, they can really change the meaning of the sentence. So put it properly. Now, let us see. What are the few takeaways to be kept in mind while writing? We have already done our pre-writing, writing and revision and editing. Now, what are the few things which you have to keep in your mind while writing? So, first thing which you need to do is don't fear. Don't fear from your mistakes. If you are writing for the first time, you may mistakes. You will definitely make lot of mistakes. So, don't fear that, oh, mere se to hui nahi raha. It's not like that. It will not work like this. Just keep on writing. Observing and reading are the food for writing. So graze them as much as you can. You can't think all the times. You can't be creative enough to write everything at your own. So how will you get those ideas? How will you do that brainstorming or mind mapping unless and until you have lot of food for it? So observe and read. These are the two basic things. Proper planning and clear understanding of writing content. What you want to write, how you want to write, how to present it. These all things need to be very clear in your mind before writing. Pre-writing strategies play an important part, which I have already told you that pre-writing is very important part. Train your brain to think and visualize what you want to write. If you are able to visualize, if you are writing a story and you are able to visualize the things, the sequence will automatically come into your mind. So train your brain to think accordingly so that you can really put it on the paper. Fill your pen with the ink of vocabulary. Good set of vocabulary is very important. Your grammatical skills, spellings, punctuation marks, these will help you to make your writing very effective. So when you are using your pen, these should be the inks, and you please use them carefully. Start with writing a paragraph, and for this I have already made a video, you can see it, that how to develop a paragraph. That will really help you. So start with writing small paragraphs of 5-6 lines. Really want to build up your writing styles, it will really help you. Organization of the written content, that is really important. How you want to organize it, what will be the sequence, what will be the flow, what will be the order. So all these things need to be taken care of. And keep practicing and seek advice from your teacher or any other experts you want to take. Don't feel ashamed about it, that what will people say, or my mistakes will be come out. Don't worry about it if you really want to write something. So these are few of the very important points which you must keep your mind while writing. So happy writing, and thank you very much for your time and support. And if you have liked the video, then please don't forget to share this with everyone. And please subscribe the channel for more such videos, and keep advising for what you want next. Thank you very much.